Howdy, YouTube family. It's Bolt SRNA coming to you again with another day's topic. So today there's a hot thing going on in the news. It's all over Facebook and Twitter, and CNN's talking about it. Everybody's talking about it. Maureen Walsh, the senator from Washington State. She made a comment a few days ago about nurses not needing breaks because they sit around taking breaks all day, playing cards probably. And that has got people very inflamed, and I've seen it all over all social media and everywhere else online. So let's talk about it today. Let's get into what she means, whether it was right or wrong, and what we should do about it. Let's get into it. So let's get a little bit of context around this topic before we dive into it. So there in Washington State, they had passed a bill that would, or was trying to pass a bill that would state that nurses would not get nurses would get uninterrupted breaks and lunches and stuff, so that they would be able to take their lunch and not have people interrupt them and all that. Well, she jumped in and she said she needed an amendment for that that would say that critical access hospitals that had less than 25 beds, which the majority of her region apparently has a lot of those hospitals. She stated that those hospitals did not need that kind of bill or protection for their nurses because they were apparently slow enough, or she feels like they're slow enough and don't work as hard, and they play a lot of cards throughout the day and things like that. So her idea was that they don't really need it, and that's who she was referencing when she says that nurses are playing cards all day. So she wasn't talking about everybody on a whole, all the nurses in the world. She's talking about smaller hospitals. Still, is that right for her to say that? No, it is not correct for her to say that, because I seriously doubt that those nurses, even in 25 bed or less hospitals, are sitting around playing cards all day. And the dismissive nature and the tone of the way she said it was very disrespectful. And as many people have learned with the Joy Behar incident, when she said that a nurse was wearing a doctor's stethoscope, you cannot speak against one of us and not have the entire legion of nurses come down on you, because it's gonna happen. It happened to Joy Behar, it's happening to Maureen Walsh, it will happen to anyone else who speaks against nurses in a dismissive or condescending or negative way. I don't think what she was anticipating is that nurses are not just LPNs and RNs. Nurses is a huge umbrella term that pretty much is synonymous with healthcare. We are the people who have a technical certificate from a community college who are certified nursing assistants. Those are nurses of a certain type, all the way up to PhD and doctoral nurses who own their own practices and are providing anesthesia, and even the previous Surgeon General, interim Surgeon General, was a PhD nurse. So, and including hospital administrators, people who run corporations and companies, those are nurses. Nurses is a term that embodies all of us. So if you say something about nurses, you've suddenly got millions of people, some of which are in powerful positions, very upset at you. So Joy Behar learned that lesson, and sadly now that Maureen is as well, you would think that more people would already know this and not speak out in a negative way or condescending tone against nurses. Now, I'm just gonna insert some memes here so you can kind of see some of the conversation that I've been seeing online. Some of the funny ones, some of them are a little bit more serious, but I just think it's entertaining to see and informative to see just what everyone's saying about this topic. And you'll even notice some of the commentary are from physicians and other people who are not paramedics, people who are not nurses at all, but they are friends of a nurse or work in the same environment as a nurse. And when somebody attacks us, not only does all of the nurses jump back on, but our friends who are also in healthcare with us, they attack as well. So it's a dangerous game to play to speak out against nurses. Now, I know in my 4 years that I worked in the ICU, I don't think I ever played cards. And that's a comment that you'll see a lot of nurses making, is I never played cards or whatever. That's kind of an older person's entertainment, I would say. I don't think many people under 50 probably play cards in their free time. What do you guys think about this? Do you feel like what she said was okay? Do you feel like people are blowing it too much out of proportion, or do you feel like they're doing it just the amount of justice it deserves? Should she have more punishment? Should she be harassed more? Should her office be called more times? I'm sure I saw a post recently that somebody had been calling their office and sending things to their website so much that the website had broken, or that it could no longer receive messages or something like that. So I think she may have got the message at this point. But the reason I think people take this very personal and people are very quick to jump on board and lash back at this is because nurses as a whole are very marginalized. They're very mistreated. They're, you know, patients can hurt them and they can't do anything back. They're underpaid in a lot of times, a lot of situations. They're overworked. There's mandatory overtime. There's all kinds of things with nurses where they get the bad end of a deal. And so when you get mistreated all the time like that, and you give and give and give, and you're constantly being taken advantage of and being told increase your HCAHPS scores or chart more or make sure every call light's answered immediately all the time and pass out 100 narcotics to everybody, but then the minute there's an opioid crisis, it's like, what were you doing? Why are you handing out so much drugs? It's like you're stuck in the middle no matter what you do as a nurse. You are always, at least I will say as a bedside nurse, you're very much stuck in the middle of a hierarchy of people, and you're getting everything from the top down on you, and you're also supposed to be managing the people on the bottom here, including all your patients and stuff. And so from both sides, you're getting stress compounding on you. And then people wonder, why does everyone go to nurse practitioner school? Because you get so sick of today's modern American healthcare, you're stuck in the middle as an LPN or an RN, and you have no power to change your environment. So you go back to school and get your master's or doctorate so you can do something that you can help people and be there for patients and do things for people and not be constantly sandwiched between two powerful forces that you never can win against. So I could talk about this all day, about the injustice that nurses face. But I'm more interested in what you guys think about it. You guys are probably all out there practicing as nurses, or maybe you're in nursing school, or maybe you were, you know, friends of a nurse and just interested in this kind of healthcare topic. So comment down below and let me know, what do you think we should do about this topic? What do you think we should say to Maureen? Do you think it was fair, unfair of the way she said that and how she kind of was condescending and flippant to nursing and as a whole? What do you think? You guys can also reach out to me on Instagram or Twitter. It's BoltSRNA over there. If you like this video, you like more topics like this and stuff that's current going on in the news, let me know by hitting that like button and subscribing. And I'll that's my way of knowing, like, people like this stuff, so I'll know to keep doing it. But anyway, that's Bolt out.